artificial harmonics are a great way for you to produce notes that are higher than maybe what you can normally reach on the harmonic series on any particular string. So artificial harmonics sound like this. That was just on the D string. So what I'm doing is with my thumb, I'm pressing down a note, essentially creating a new string with a new set of harmonic, a new harmonic series. And then either my middle finger or my ring finger are just touching harmonics. So they're called artificial harmonics because they're artificially created by your thumb. You can just set your thumb on the string and have it'll have the same effect. I found that to be a little more unstable. I think at least with my instrument, the notes don't come out as clearly if I just set my thumb down, but if I push down, that helps that note speak a little better. The bow needs to be fast and fairly close to the bridge because you are working with harmonics, and harmonics need a lot of bow. If you're having trouble producing a sound, I would say like probably 80% of the time it's a bow issue. So check your bow, make sure you're using a really fast bow, faster than maybe what you think you will need, and that will hopefully get the note to speak. I practice harmonics by artificial harmonics by doing scales. So I'll say I'm gonna push my thumb down on D, touch a fourth above my thumb, and do a scale that way, and it'll sound like this. I do this sometimes with a tuner to work on intonation and make sure that I'm getting those pitches in tune. I try to focus on having a consistent tone. Some of my notes on that scale really struggled to speak a little bit, and that was a bow issue. As far as the notes that you're producing, if you touch a fourth above your thumb, that produces a pitch that's two octaves above your thumb. So my thumb is touching D, my middle finger is touching G, and the note that comes out is a D two octaves above where my thumb is at. If I touch a fifth above my thumb is on D, my middle finger is touching A, the note that's coming out is an A that's an octave above where my middle finger is at. When composers notate artificial harmonics, it can be super confusing. Like, are they notating the note that you're touching, or are they notating the note that they want to come out? There's no kind of standard way to notate artificial harmonics, and so sometimes it can get really confusing. So best of luck with figuring out how a composer is notating an artificial harmonic. What else? The closer your finger gets to your thumb, the higher the pitch. Which is opposite of just playing like normal notes, right? The higher up you go normally, the higher the note. But here, the more you go this direction, the higher the note. So touching like a second above your thumb, I don't know what pitch that is, I didn't check before I started this, is very high. So keep that in mind. When you're working on scales, as you go higher, your fingers have to get closer together. Just the physics of our instrument, right? It's the same with like doing a scale. A whole step up here is like several inches apart, whereas a whole step when you're up here is like a few centimeters. It's the same concept with artificial harmonics. As you go up, your hands have to your thumb and whatever finger you're touching the note with have to slowly come together. I practice that with just doing one octave scales. I'll touch like a third above my thumb and then a fourth and then a fifth. I'll do them on all the strings. I mean, the E string is kind of a bear to do artificial harmonics on, but it has a really cool sonority to the note. Artificial harmonics are fun. They have just like a wispy, thin sound to them that I think just can add really, really great flavor to whatever you're playing. yeah, I think that's all I got on artificial harmonics. Go have fun with that one.